So thank you for joining. Welcome. My name is Blair Boone-Migura. I am the founder and executive director of the Art Song Preservation Society of New York. We have been in existence since 2010, and our primary focus has been, or mission, has been to reignite a resurgence and interest in the art song repertoire. And we do that through masterclasses with esteemed and gifted professionals like we have today, Ms. Raehann Bryce-Davis, mezzo-soprano. And we do this through recitals, we have a vocal competition, so an array of, and a community outreach program, so an array of various programs to help educate both singers and the public about this beautiful repertoire, which is sadly been in decline over the years. So with that, I just want to thank the singers for their participation today. We can't do this without great talent, and we certainly have that out at our disposal this afternoon. I certainly cannot do this without the professionals, the great singers, teachers, pianists that helped to make this possible by imparting their experience and talents and gifting that to the world so that we can understand through their immense talent and knowledge just how special this repertoire is. And I can't do that, I certainly can't do that without some of our donors. Some of you have made donations today, so thank you very much for that. We say that no amount is too small or too large if you're willing to give. So, and we do this also with two specific donors that I'd like to name today. The Creative Engagement Award, which is administered by LMCC, which is a wonderful, wonderful opportunity for arts organizations and local artists in New York to help expose the Manhattan community to the arts. Not that they're typically before a pandemic, I would say, we had no worries about Manhattanites being exposed to the arts. So it's been a particularly gratifying time to receive grants right now because, as we all know, it's been a very difficult year. So LMCC has been wonderful in letting us know that they are behind us because they understand that at the end of the day, there are artists at the that we're trying to impact artists' lives, whether it be the teachers who are teaching this or the young singers and pianists with whom we work. So this filters down. So they wanted to make sure that we still got the grant, even though we're living through a pandemic. And the other entity that I'd like to thank is UMass, the Upper Manhattan Empowerment Zone Development Corporation, for their grant and support. And they specifically target arts organizations and artists who are on the Upper West Side of Manhattan. And so that's important to note because typically, historically, in the past several years, our events, our masterclasses, recitals, our festivals have all taken place at the Manhattan School of Music, which is located in Morningside in the Upper West Side of Manhattan. So their support is critical, particularly this year, because they're allowing us to do these events virtually because of the pandemic. But the great news about that is it has allowed us to invest some forward thinking on and strategies how to move forward when we're past this pandemic. We never thought about presenting our events virtually. So now it's great to know that we can do this. We can reach a broader range of singers because we have singers who are singing in today from Atlanta, from Oregon, from California. This yesterday was from Germany and Italy. So it's great to be able to reach more singers and reach the public even in deeper kind of encroachment into the public by going virtually. And we have teachers who now don't have to travel to Manhattan if, let's say, there's a pandemic going on. They can still teach. So it's actually been wonderful to figure this piece out that once we're beyond a pandemic, we'd like to figure out ways to continue to offer live events, but also virtual events as well. Okay, so that's enough of my spiel. Thank you to everyone who helped to make today possible. And then the last thing I'll note before we move on to the day's event is that we have one final masterclass this season, and that's in April, and it's with the indomitable Thomas Grubb, specialist of French song. He also went to Manhattan School of Music, much like today's artist as well. So Manhattan School of Music is very well represented with our organization because we have so many great artists that come through those doors. That's on April 10th, and again, it's French song. And then we're going to take a bit of a break, and we'll return this summer with Summer of Song. So if you're a singer interested in singing in those masterclasses this summer, just let me know. I can give you a list of the opportunities that are available there. Okay, so today is Dramatic Interpretation of Song, and it's with Ms. Raehann Bryce-Davis, a truly gifted and special mezzo-soprano. If you haven't already seen her video, we'd like to begin today showing some of that. It's called To the Afflicted, and what really got me about this video is it came at such a truly critical and pivotal time last year when all of us were just feeling discouraged, disheartened, lost. And I felt like this wonderful artist really kind of encapsulated what so many musicians, singers, pianists, the orchestra at the Met were feeling as they saw opportunity after opportunity after opportunity just disappear right before their very eyes. And you have to understand, I mean, as you all know, this is a livelihood. So I thought it was just such a great representation that many of us could relate to. So I'd like to begin there rather than go through Ms. Bryce-Davis's bio, because the bio is there and accessible to you to read about her distinctive credits. So we would just get a sense of who will be teaching the artist today. We're going to look at To the Afflicted, by Ms. Raehann Bryce-Davis, and notably, she has another video coming out just this coming week on March 26th that you can find on the website of LA Opera, and she'll tell us a little bit about that as well. It's called Brown Sounds, again, coming out March 26th at 2 p.m., a new release. But in the meantime, here is To the Afflicted. Thank you. Wonderful. That's amazing. It's true, just to see that again, they're reminding of all the stress we were feeling last summer with the Black Lives Matter demonstrations that was going on throughout the country, the stress of the pandemic, loss of employment. Thank you for that, Raehann. Thank you so much. I'm sure you'll have many questions about.
Okay, Peloton, who's ready to work? Kendall's 30-minute pump ride.
Sorry.
That should be fun.
Get out home motivation.
That wasn't supposed to happen. Technical glitch. All right. So let's get on to singing. First of all, let's put our hands together for our wonderful guest artist today, Raehann Bryce-Davis.
Thank you, guys. It's so amazing to be here. I'm so excited that we get to make music together and talk about a topic that's so very near and dear to my heart. I love that the commercial said, "Hey, you guys, who's ready to work?" Because now it's time to work. But I think the only way we get art song to be preserved, as is the title of this organization, is if we really make it meaningful and relevant and truthful to today's audience. And that's such a huge part of what we're talking about today, is how to make it real, how to make it specific, how to make it relevant. And that's my biggest passion in life. As you saw, I took a bel canto aria written hundreds of years ago and told the story of what we're experiencing today. So I look forward to continuing this with all of you as we push our art form forward. So who's our first victim?
So first up we have LaToya Lewis, who will be singing Gretchen am Spinnrade. And I just put the text of the song down in the comments of the box for anyone who doesn't have. I'll be the dreaded timekeeper, so I'll keep us on time today. So LaToya, take it away.
All right, it's very high tech over here, so let me just make sure I got this thing on.
Mine Armbrust hin, mine Herz schwer, ich finde.
Okay, sorry, the music just turned off. I don't know why. Hold on, technical difficulties. Give me 1 second.
There's always a first. So I guess I've never had this happen before, but it makes me think this is akin to the pianist just getting up in the middle of an audition and running to the restroom more. So, yes. Welcome to ASPS, where firsts happen every day.
Okay, let's see. I don't know. I think maybe the battery died or something. Let me just try this again. No. All right. I think what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to connect it through my cell phone because I had it connected through my laptop.
Do you want to maybe take a moment to work on that? We can actually move maybe to Olivia and start.
Yeah, thank you.
Why don't we do that? Because that's a little discombobulating, I imagine. And that good to try and sing. Take a few moments and collect yourself. Olivia, would you mind going next?
Not a problem. I think
okay, we'll do that. And I'll put the text of Olivia's song in there, in the drop box.
I think I'm ready. Is everyone ready?
Yes.
Okay, great. This is Nuvoletta by Samuel Barber.
Nuvoletta, in her light dress, spun of 16 shimmers, was lost.
she childishly called. She was alone. All her newbie companions were asleep with the squirrels. She tried all the winsome, winsome ways her province had taught her. She turns a swift elasticity. Technical difficulties. Sorry. First by ones and twos, then by threes and fours, at last by fives and sixes of sevens, for the tired ones are waking, as we weep now with them. Thank you.
So beautiful.
Thank you.
How did you choose this song?
This was actually recommended to be met by a college voice teacher when I was a senior. I sang it on my senior recital, and then, but I love the piece, and I really love languages, and I just think it's, the text is fantastic. And so when I heard about a masterclass like this, I thought that this piece would be really, you know, it's a very rich text to work on dramatic interpretation and that kind of thing. So I brought it back.
Most certainly. There are certainly lots of scrumptious words to play with. So can you tell us what happens in this song in a short synopsis?
Well, it's about this girl named Nuvoletta. Short is hard, you know, when you sing the whole piece. I don't exactly know how to describe her. Well, she's this kind of willowy thing, and she seems kind of independent and kind of her own person. And she's alone. She's looking around her house, and she's feeling kind of alone. And she goes through this kind of journey of her thoughts. And by the end, she kind of goes away. She's a bit of a transient person.
A transient person, what does that mean?
That means that it just seems the nature of this poetry and the nature of who she is. It seems like she's, it's a little vignette of her, and I guess this is her kind of coming into our lives and then floating away.
Is she a human being?
Well, I've actually... I have wondered this, and I don't know. Yes, but I almost picture her more of like a fairy, almost kind of.
Person. I like it. Make it a fairy, because I think that gives you more freedom to play. And in general, you're the one performing it, so you just make the choice. It doesn't matter if anybody agrees with the choice, but you have to make the choice. Because if you're having these option of, you know, she's kind of this and she's kind of that, that's what we see is just generic blah and not a specific character. So I like a fairy. Let's pick a fairy and let's do that. Can you speak for me? Can you start? Can you maybe just start the first verse, and can you speak it with all of the scrunchious consonants that you can enjoying? And I and be the fairy.
Okay. Nuvoletta, in her light dress, spun of cistine shimmers, was looking down on them, leaning over the banisters and listening all she childishly could. She was alone. All her newbied companions were sleeping with the squirrels. She tried all her winsome, onesome ways her four winds had taught her. She tossed her sphumas de lacinous hair, like la princesse de la petite Bretagne.
Okay, so great. So first of all, we establish actually Nuvoletta is not speaking, it is a narrator speaking. So great. Who is the narrator? What is the character of the narrator, and what is the relationship to Nuvoletta?
Well, in the, this is originally from Finnegan's Wake.
Mm-hmm.
And in Finnegan's Wake, it's just kind of James Joyce writing, you know, so
you as Olivia,
who
are you telling the story?
Right. Who am I? Well, I suppose, I'll make a decision.
Mm-hmm.
I am someone who is, I'm also in the house. She thinks she's alone, but actually I'm watching her.
Okay. I like that. That's very interesting. And where in the house is she in relationship to you?
Well, she's kind of in the entryway, because there's a stairwell, right? She has to be looking down over the banisters. And
mm-hmm.
And so I'd say that maybe I'm peering in the window. And
okay.
See her kind of go through.
That sounds I like that. I like that, but totally use it. Okay. Like, maybe sometimes you can't totally see her, so you're like, yeah. Wait, what did she do? And a huge part of a gift that you have is your eyes. And when you make these decisions very clearly of where are you, where is she, and you place her specifically there and you're looking at her, your eyes aren't like wandering here and there like they were the first time that you ran it. Okay. This time when you spoke the text, it was so much clearer, so much crisper, and all of a sudden we heard the words and we were with you in the story.
Okay.
Which I loved. So can we start it again? Can you be very clear about where you are, where she is, and how you feel about what she's doing?
Okay.
Lovely, lovely. Another element we can add to this is, who are you speaking to?
It's definitely telling, you know, it's funny, as I started singing this, I realized that most of the time when I sing this, I kind of think that I'm partially am Nuvoletta, even though it's a third person, you know, almost like she's telling a story about herself. But if we're going with the fact that I'm watching her, I could be telling this story later on to someone, you know, I saw this very strange fairy person, and this is what she was doing, you know.
This is also a very possible. It's just, you just have to make the choice which of the two you want to do, because okay. Those will look very differently.
That's true. Okay.
So which one are you choosing?
Whether being her or telling someone else the story.
Or
watching her and
telling it later. Yeah.
Okay. I don't know off the top of my head. I guess I'll just go with I'm there. I'm there watching her.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. And you could in your head, you could make it both. It's a very long song. Yeah. Right now you could be telling someone and then you meld into like, and now you're there, and then you meld it. But those are things you have to be very specific about in your mind, or else it all just reads as a wash of genericness to us.
Sure.
Cool. So I liked that you started again with much more magic. I encourage you, as soon as the piano begins to play, that's your world.
Yeah.
So right now the piano started and your eyes were still like regular Olivia. Yeah. And then you went, Nuvoletta, that's too late. It's too late. As soon as it's hard now because, you know, you're pressing play on the piano. When we're on stage, your world is creates the piano, right? So when you come up and it's like the world and then the piano and I'm here and we're ready to celebrate and tell this story and, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah. But I encourage you before, as soon as the piano starts or before, if you can, tell us the story. And you can go on if you want, because otherwise we're going to do this beginning 20 million times.
Okay. I will continue from where we stop.
You can't say a word like plumestillationous hair and give us girl. Okay. This is when, like, it's a completely ridiculous word. Yeah. And you have to exaggerate it. So much of this language is exaggerated. So you need to live on level 150 for us to like be like, okay, we'll come with you on the journey. But if you're like in this kind of half selling it world, we lost you. We've completely lost you. So give me all, you were doing such a great job with the text. We heard so much more of it. Okay. Can you go even further and be ridiculous with all of your consonants and the joy of Nuvoletta? Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. Her four wings had taught her she tossed her sail still lost in a sail like La Princesse de la Petite Bretagne.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Lovely, 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 lovely. Can we see you toss your hair? Can we see? Oh, yeah. Can you imitate? She tossed her hair like the swan. She listened. Ah, da, 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 da. Can you just be like completely ridiculous for a minute? Like, just be like so ridiculous right now.
Okay.
Like, nothing. I don't want anything proper. I want you to be absolutely ridiculous.
Okay.
She turns the swim as the loss in his hell, like La Princesse de la Petite Bretagne. Did that feel ridiculous?
It didn't feel terrible. It felt a little over the top, but
and I would say that's not even scratching the surface. Okay. Can you go like 20,000 times? Like, you're playing with a 2-year-old and you're like, she tossed her hair like the spot. Like, just tell us the story. So you thought that was ridiculous and that's not far enough.
Okay.
So go further than that. Like, be completely, okay. Why don't you say the words?
She tossed her swoomer stelas in his hair.
Like, yeah. So proper. So no, proper. Yeah.
She tossed her swoomer stelas in his hair like La Princesse de la Petite Bretagne.
That sounded so lovely and such like a very proper opera singer.
Okay.
What does it look like to be so ridiculous? Like, I'm like, hey, Olivia, can you tell me that story that you told me about that princess, the blah, blah, blah? Can you tell me that story? Tell me that story.
And then she tossed her swoomer stelas in his hair like La Princesse de la Petite Bretagne.
Yes, that got real.
Okay.
Yes. What's the difference?
More energy in the second one for sure, and more fluctuation in my voice, I think.
Yes. Yes. And you spoke it, and the da 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 da, like, has how you would as a human being versus the other one. She tossed her hair like a swan, which is not real. We don't care. That version that you just did started absolutely sparking the magic. Also vocally for you, technically, that's going to change everything and you will have much more overtones and it will be easier for you technically. So let's do it again. Can you speak it again? And then, yeah.
She tossed her swoomer stelas in his hair like La Princesse de la Petite Bretagne.
Who's the princess? Who is she?
She's in the portrait.
It's wonderful. Is she pretty?
Yes, she's beautiful.
Okay, so tell me again what happens then?
Then she smiled after herself like the image of the pose of the daughter of the Emperor of Ireland.
What? That's crazy! And then what happened?
And she sighed after herself as were she born to bride with Tristior and Tristissimus.
What? Tristissimus? And then what happened?
But sweet Maronine, she might fare as well have carried her Desur to Florida.
Yes. Okay. But do you feel how different this feels?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Sing it like this. Let's sing and do this. Do this okay. First.
So go back to just before she talks.
Wherever you want, I just want you to speak and tell me a really great story.
Okay. She turned.
No. Went back to an opera singer. I don't want it. I don't want it. You gave me magic. I demand magic again.
Okay.
She tossed her hair like a sponge.
Okay.
She tried all the winds then what happened?
And she rounded her minions, arms like Mrs. Cornwallis West.
Cool. Cool. Who is Mrs. Cornwallis West?
Mrs. Cornwallis West is the... Trying to pause this, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no worries.
She is the... she's the wife of a general, Cornwallis.
And how does she look?
She looks kind of stern.
Okay, so give us stern. So all of these are really different people, and you have to give us different worlds. So first she tossed this one, tossed her hair with her spongulous hair, and then she rounded her hands and she was very stern. Yeah, so like literally we need night and day in your characterizations. Because this is such a ridiculous song and so childish and such fairy music, we need you to just go the extremes, like jump from this one and then it's that one and then it's this one and then it was like this one, and then she's like this. We need you to like go the extra mile in energy.
Okay.
What would happen if you just do it a cappella?
Yeah, I can do it a cappella. That's totally fine. Okay. Yeah. And she smiled after herself.
What would happen before you start singing? Do something that makes you feel ridiculous, like
okay.
And she smiled after herself, like the image of the post of the daughter of the Emperor of Ireland.
Cool. I really mean do something that makes you feel ridiculous.
Ridiculous, okay.
Like if sometimes when I'm doing these, when I'm recording videos and I need to look jovial, whatever, I'm like, ah! Hi, my name is Raehann Bryce-Davis and I'm a blah, blah, blah. It changes your energy. And I'm not kidding. I'm giving you like real techniques of like how to change energies. Okay. They won't see this part of it. You just do something ridiculous. Like, oh, she's hot. Yeah.
Okay. Be ridiculous. Okay. Yay! I don't know.
Yeah. Cool. Do something else. Do something till you feel ridiculous. Yay! I love it. Yeah, that was great. That was great. Do it again. Do it whatever you want.
Okay.
And she smiled after herself, like the image of the pose of the daughter of the Emperor of Ireland. And she said after herself, as were she born to a bride with tristis.
Yay. What's the character of this one?
Very, very sad. And
tristis.
Okay.
You can enjoy that. Tristis. Yeah, like go, we have the super happy, we have the super stern, we have the super sad, and you can use your consonants to really make that jump. But I congratulate you hugely on the energy that you just found. And I will point out to you, if you listen back to this later, your vibrato is more even, your tone is more forward and more, like, it helps you. What I'm saying sounds absolutely ridiculous, but it helps you technically as a singer. It helps you tell the story. And this poem is 1000% about telling the story.
Yeah, it feels a lot better already.
Yay. Anybody else have any thoughts on how it was different or how you received it differently?
It was beautiful work, I think. Beautiful change in character and in voice. It's amazing how what you were saying, Raehann, what you do off to the side, and then all of a sudden, you know, they don't see that, but that's exactly what we got to see. It's like, once she was ridiculous, the voice came alive.
Yes, as a piggyback, I think that the movement made a lot of difference, you know, made a whole... lot of difference.
Her voice sounded a lot freer.
It felt freer. Thank you.
That's what I was going to say too. Like, when you had her free herself up, everything loosened up. And it's almost like I didn't even notice that it was tight until it wasn't tight. So that was amazing.
Thank you.
Anybody else, just before I cut off anyone? But huge, huge difference, Olivia. What do you think, what are your takeaways?
Well, this is an area in which I struggle, the kind of emotional and, you know, the energy of performing. I haven't had a lot of like formal acting training, and so I think this was really helpful, just showing me what I think is not enough for on stage at all.
Correct. Yeah. And I give you full permission to play fully. Always. Brava.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Olivia. Okay, well, next we will now circle back to LaToya and Gretchen, and hopefully the spinning wheel will keep spinning this time.
Yes, it's really funny because I played it 1,000 times before, and then suddenly when it was time for me to get up and sing, that's when it didn't work. So let's try this again.
Oh,
Bravi.
Thank you. Sorry, my cat joined in at the end.
I love it. I love it. It was great. Really beautiful voice and really beautiful commitment. How long have you been singing the song?
So I started singing it back in undergrad. And so it might seem like, oh, you've been singing it for a while, but in undergrad, I had such a different voice.
Yeah.
So I wasn't singing it as like open throat as I could be. So that's kind of why I have this as a crutch here too, because I'll do it in concert and stuff like that because it's a nice, fun piece.
Uh-huh.
But I just feel like in this setting, I wanted to pay a lot closer attention to how I'm singing it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Great. So I think this piece is very different from the piece that Olivia sang, because if you could use one verb to describe Gretchen's feelings in the song, what would it be?
Ooh, one verb. Well, out of control is not a verb.
Give me a word. Give me a word.
To desperation. Describe.
Desperation. Okay. What else?
Something
active.
Something active. She is. She's on.
Can I give you mine?
Yeah.
To me, it's. She's yearning. It's a yearning.
Okay. Yeah.
The whole thing is a long, stretched out yearning.
Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm.
And so in opposition to Olivia's, that was all about consonants, Gretchen's is all about vowels. It's vowels that are going to take you all the way through that. That's this whole thing is just, it's one long sigh. Can you do this? Can you put your hands here?
And yep.
Like a more, just do like a mourning wailing. Yes. Can you do the wail and then just start it? Minor. Whatever. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Minor.
Come to the bottom of your side. Minor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me try that again.
Yeah.
Minor.
Yeah. I liked very much your minor. You kept spinning, you kept it going, and then you came back off how you usually do.
Yeah.
You start all your things really engaged, and then you go like, you let it like do what it wants. You're not allowed to do that. You need to stay with it the whole freaking time.
Yeah.
Staccato is the name of the game.
Yeah.
So do it again, do the sigh, and then keep going.
Okay.
Yeah, but I want you to commit to the sigh. Right now you're just going, and I want, go like this. Go like this.
Yep.
I'll tell you, when I'm in a recording session, I'm like this. Mm. And then I'm stomping. Stomp on the ground. Stomp. No, real stomp. Stomp hard. Stomp hard. Really commit. I mean, if you need to take your shoes off, take your shoes off.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to.
Do it.
Okay.
Do it. Stomp. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then like there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really commit.
Yeah.
Take off the necklace. Take it off, girl.
Yep.
We see off. That you look beautiful. We appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. I did it for you. Thank you.
Now let's get real. Here we go. Okay. Okay. Now from here, do the and then start.
Minor.
No. Do you see how disconnected that is?
Yes, I know. I'm like feeling it. I'm like, what am I doing?
Yeah, so don't do that. Minor is in. Better.
But I'm feeling it.
Try. The old school Italian singers would say that the great singers always had an inner cry.
Mm.
Even if it's a happy song, there was always an inner do that.
Why can't I do this?
Yeah. I like it. Don't judge it. Just do it.
Yep.
Yes. Now sing. Yes. Don't judge it. Yes. Sing. Yes. I like it better. You're coming off of it less.
Yeah.
But it needs to be even faster. And you can do that by repeating the vowels. Minor. That's what you're thinking inside. Minor. Some people think about it like that with the repeated vowels. Some people inside are thinking minor 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 because otherwise we get what you were doing. Minor room. You check out. Out 1 second in. Yeah. And in a song that dramatically is all about. That's the dramatic thing of this song, and that's why I'm working with you on legato, because in this case,
yeah,
you do that, we're home free.
Yeah.
So okay. Let's do that.
Okay. So once again, without music, right? And like all of the all the tools you're saying, right? Okay. Okay. Minor voice. Mine Herz ist schwer, ich will immer und nimmer
mehr. Yes. Yes. Do you see how much energy it takes to keep it steady?
Yes.
Okay. Stay there. Keep going. I don't know if the, maybe back away from your microphone because I want to hear you better and it's like maxing out. It's like too much amazing voice.
Oh, I'm like trying to, okay, let's see. What if I go to, like, down the hallway?
Yeah, do it.
Okay. So keep going, right?
Yeah.
With
all of your inner cry.
Okay. Ist mir das Brot, die ganze Welt ist mir vergelt.
Cool. You're slowing down as you go.
Yeah.
Stay on it, girl. Stay on it. It's fast. It's fast energy. It's fast flow. It's fast. It's you know, there's a water can flow at different speeds. You know, there's some like slow flowing rivers, and this is a fast one. This is give me the fast one. Give me the fast one. The fast learning the inner cry.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Observation. Your vibrato is naturally fast. And what your norm is very slow because you're holding. Yeah?
Yeah.
Naturally, your voice wants to freaking go.
Yeah.
And so we are now hearing your true color and your true phonation. This is amazing and this is stunning. Yeah. But you don't do it on every note. You go back to old habits sometimes. So I think just go through the whole thing now. I don't know how much time we have. Go through the whole thing now and just focus on spinning. I'm not going to stop you. Just spin and just cry and just.
Okay.
Because you have to get used to that.
I really do. Okay.
Meine Ruhe ist hin, mein Herz ist schwer, ich bin noch, ich bin.
Of that, you were flying, girl.
Yeah,
you were flying, and then at the end, you sat on it.
Yeah.
You're like, okay, that was enough work. I'm done for now. But do you feel the difference?
Yes, a lot more engagement, and also that was freeing. The way I was saying, I was like, oh, Olivia sounds so free now, but like. I needed to free myself up too.
Right.
And so that's what it definitely felt like. I didn't have to make vibrato happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. And it's just an energy thing. It's a vowel thing. It's a flow thing. It's a not grabbing thing. Mm. And this is not a technical class. So I'm not trying to touch your technique, but about this piece, it needs, that's what this piece is.
Yeah.
A version of that. And so if you're giving us, you're not giving us, and it just so happens that doing that is going to help your technique.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you have like the world between what you can do and what you always do, you can go so much further. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like you're, I don't know what kind of voice they tell you you have. Do they tell you you have a big voice, like a big dramatic voice? I can't tell from the computer.
Some people say, okay, one day you'll be, one day you'll do butterfly or like, you know, and another say, oh, your voice is too big for Mozart, which I think is incorrect. Yeah. So people are all over the place.
Right. So it's the big voice drama, Shana's, that you're getting, right? Mm-hmm. So I think that gets in your head and you're like, I need to make big sound. Mm-hmm. And that's crap. That hurts you in the end. If you think, I need to speak and I need to flow. Mm-hmm. That's all you need to think about.
Yeah.
And then your voice will tell everyone what it needs to sing.
Mm.
But if you stay holding on to it and creating a color that I think you think should be,
mm-hmm. you
never even get to hear the sparkle and the shimmer and the beauty that is your voice. You mm-hmm. have all of the capabilities to like roar when you need to roar, but also just float and shimmer when you need to float and shimmer. You have all of that in your voice. So stay on this repeated vowels. Keep the inner cry. Keep the, yeah. But go, let it go. Let it go and let it speak, let it spin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
Yeah. What are your takeaways?
Oh, my takeaway. Well, you know, it's interesting because remember I was saying, oh, I sang this when I was in undergrad and my voice was different. Well, my voice was just primarily shimmer. And then they'd be like, oh, but okay. Then I got to grad school and they're like, oh my gosh, your voice is huge. And I'm like, I don't think it is. And they're like, but your high notes sound like this. So I always have felt like this hybrid of something. And so when you said, you know, when you release your voice, you will show people what you're supposed to sing. That is my biggest takeaway, where it's like, let me just let my voice speak for itself.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah.
Brava.
Thank Good. You.
Fantastic job. Thank you. Thank you so much, Raehann. And thank you, Latoya, for that beautiful work you both did together. We are moving on to our next singer. Our sole male on the program today, inject a little bit of alternate DNA, José Maldonado, baritone, going to sing for us. I'll put the text in the Dropbox for everyone.
Hello. Hello, my name is José Luis Maldonado, and I will be singing Mattinata by Leon Cavallo. But a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful morning in Italian. L'aurora di bianco vestita già l'uscioli schiude al gran sol, e già con le rose sue dita carezza de fiori lo stuol. Commosso un fremito arcano, intorno il creato già par, e tu non ti testi er in vano, mi sto qui dolente a cantar. Metti anche tu
veste bianca e sfiori l'uscia al tuo cantare. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei nasce l'amor. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e schiudi l'uscia al tuo cantare. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei, ove tu sei, nasce l'amor.
Bravo. What a voice.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Oh,
I started shaking. My legs are shaking.
Oh, well, we didn't hear it. We didn't hear it. The thing that's unfair about tenors is you guys just stand there and give us no dramatic interpretation sometimes. And we're like, yay! Which is not fair for the rest
of us. I'm not a tenor, though.
What?
I'm not a tenor.
In terms of? You're a baritone.
Yes.
Really?
I'm glad I'm not a tenor. You know that Gerald Moore song?
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, this is the medium high version. This isn't the Pavarotti high version. This is the medium high version.
Well, I congratulate you then on your flexibility, on your high, on your flow.
Thanks.
Interesting. Okay. Anyway, let's actually work on making it a bit more specific, shall we? Who are you?
A tenor. I'm a young man in love with this woman.
Yeah.
Yes.
Where are you?
I would say I'm outside of her house, like those serenades, or I'm waiting for her outside her home.
Okay. Where is her home? What country? What town?
Oh, I imagine a countryside. So maybe somewhere off in Palermo, maybe in the countryside of Palermo.
Okay. Have you been there?
Home.
Have you been there?
No, not Palermo. Not yet.
Okay.
I've been to Assisi.
Can you pick somewhere where you know?
Assisi.
You've been there.
I've been to Assisi.
Okay. So you see the specific house. Where in front of the house are you standing or behind?
By the fountain.
Lovely. Okay. And the fountain is on, it's flowing. That's the background. You hear that sound?
Yes. The
nice.
I mean, it's creating now as it's happening, actually. So thank
That's
you.
Great. That's great. I like it. And is her window open?
Slightly. It's cracked.
So at the beginning of the song, is she already like listening to you, or do you have to make her open the window?
No, she's asleep.
Okay.
So in the text, I even say, you won't wake up with the day, because it's talking about the day coming up. And so I'm saying, I'm here singing for you. Wake up, like, and come out in white, like the dawn is coming in white.
And does she?
And then at the end, I say, if without you, the light misses you, but with you, the light is born.
And does she come out at the end?
Oh, yeah. In my world, yes.
Okay. So you can even make that happen dramatically at the end of it, where you are, love is born, and then she opens the window, and you're like, yay!
That last
thing.
Yeah. It has a little stinger.
Absolutely. And that's the opening the window. I like that. Okay. So... can we start from the top again and really feel your, is it hot or is it cold?
I'd say it's cool.
It's cool.
Nice LA cool.
Okay.
It's the morning.
Yeah.
It's going to be a hot day. I'm sure it's going to be a hot day.
Okay. But it's cool right now. Great. Yes. Okay. So we said it's the dawn. So it's like
Yeah. So when it talks about the dawn's dressed in white, I would imagine that's like the fog.
Uh-huh.
So I wouldn't think it's too hot yet.
Right. So it's like 5 a.m., 6 a.m. maybe, depending on the time of year, I suppose.
I guess. Cool. Oof, that's early. Yes.
Cool. Where are you coming from? It's very early for you. How long have you been? When did you get there? You just got there?
Well, I guess I just got there. If I'm up that early and I'm in Italy, I probably went to church.
Okay. And are you kind of out of breath because you just got there, or have you been like just standing there for a while?
I'm out of breath. I just got there.
I like that. Okay. So can you start it, and can you just arrive on screen and be like, the dawn dressed in white has already opened the door. Give us that energy. Okay. Yeah. I like it. I like it. I love it. I love it. I love it. You have more time than you think you do.
Yeah, I do.
So you can either come on slower. You can come on later. You can come on and then like look around like, where is she? I know it's one of those windows. Which one is it? Oh, there she is. I wonder if she's awake. Do you think she's going to talk to me? Do you think she's going to open the window? You have time to think all those thoughts. Yeah, I think that'll be your most interesting thing. But don't come on and then like wait for your vocal entrance. Yeah, you have to fill all that space with details, with specificity.
Okay.
L'aurora di bianco vestita già l'uscio dischiude al gran sol, di già con le rose sue dita carezza di fiori lo stuol. Commosso da un fremito arcano intorno il creato già par, e tu non ti testi, eri vano, mi sto qui dolente a cantare.
I love it. I love it. Sorry. I love it. I love it.
The energy felt so more centered, actually.
That's absolutely more centered, more organic, more honest, all of those things. So, so, so beautiful. And even within that arc, which you had that was so fantastic, you can add even more layers, right? Okay. So keeping that fresh energy, you can take a time, because you don't know what you're going to say, right? You're right. Coming up with this as you go, right? So the dawn dressed in white has already opened the door to the sun, and... just come up with the words as you're saying them, yeah.
Okay.
So let's add that element to the organicness that you were doing before as well, and that gives you different layers. So the whole time your eyes aren't like staring at her window the entire time that you are singing. You also have time to like look up and be like, whatever. There's a line that says, a mysterious trembling seems to disturb all nature. You can say that trembling is like, it's there, it disturbs all nature. You can even kind of make that, you know, that's also the trembling in your heart. Like you were saying, your legs are shaking, like use that. Sometimes the emotions that we're feeling, we can use for our character. Your character is also very nervous. So, you know, you don't know if she's going to open or not, and you don't know if you're making a total fool of yourself, and, you know, add that element of it, not just, here I am and I am singing to your window. Make it more specific.
Okay.
vestita, già l'uscio rischiude al gran sol, e già con le rose sue dita carezza di fiori lo stuol. Commosso da un fremito arcano, intorno creato già par, e tu non ti resti rivano, mi sto qui dolente a cantar. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e schiudi l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei nasce l'amor. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei, ove tu sei, nasce l'amor.
This was so lovely. So lovely. Bravo, bravo, bravo. This was lovely. What if the first time you address her, I think, is dress yourself too, right? That's the first time that you speak directly of her.
Yes.
What if the whole, you, because you have a lot of time after that, the first time you say vestiati or whatever. What if the whole time before that, you're in your own feelings and in nature, and then it, a really big deal when you look up to your window, to her window, and you say, dress yourself. Yeah. And then you sing it twice, don't you?
Right.
Yeah. So then you have to figure out how it's different the first time than it is the second time. Right. Mm. So maybe the first time is a bit questioning, like, dress, why don't you, like, are you willing to dress yourself too, like it is in nature? And then the second time is like, oh yeah, she wants this, dress yourself too. whatever it is, just give me two different colors, two okay. drastically different choices of something that's like here and then more, or then here and then more, or then less. Like, is she gonna do it? Like, maybe you start really bold and you're like, crap, did I just like do too much? Either way, just give me two choices.
Okay.
Metti anche tu la veste bianca e schiudi l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei nasce l'amor. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei, ove tu sei, nasce l'amor.
Lovely, lovely.
You're downstairs.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Bravo, bravo. You have that pausa before. What happens in that pausa?
So this last one, I saw her coming down. Like,
She came through the door. And she ran.
Before your last line or at the end?
The ba da da da. Then it does that little chung 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 chung.
Yeah, and yeah, then I love that. So let us see that on your face, because you're like da 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 da. That's but we have to see that. That's a huge change. Like, whatever it is. I mean, in your own expressions, don't do my expressions, but we have to register on your face that you've now, like, however it is that you feel about it, like, oh my gosh, I can't believe she's here. Or like, I knew she was gonna come, but here she is. Either way, either choice you make, just make a choice and let us see it. Make a bold, big choice.
Metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei. Ove tu sei.
I love it. I love it. I love it. So are you hugging her at the end?
Yeah.
Are you? You are?
Yeah, that's what she comes in and I give her.
Yeah. I like the idea, but I think visually it maybe looks a little bit silly. So just make it that she comes closer, right?
Mm.
So don't come to the point of like, meh.
Right.
Like, but do it with your eyes. I loved the difference that you made with your eyes. That was beautiful. Okay. I think we still have like 4 minutes. How long is this song?
Like two.
I love it. I love it. I want you to sing it twice with, if you feel like you have voice to sing it twice, with drastically different choices. The first time, I want you to be the most arrogant, ridiculously like pompous
a tenor.
Really? Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Give me that one and then give me the other one as like a super shy and like, I don't know if like it's gonna happen. I just want the two different characters so you play with making absolutely opposite choices.
Okay.
So first give us the like really, really big jerk who's like, oh yeah, she's coming down. Of course she is. Yeah. So play with that. Be like so way bigger than anything. Like, I feel like you have it in you. Do it. Do it. Just go 1,000%.
L'aurora di bianco vestita, già l'uscio rischiude il gran sol, e già con le rose sue dita, carezza di fiori lo stuol. Commosso un fremito arcano, intorno al creato già par, e tu non ti desti ed in vano mi sto qui volente a cantar. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei, nasce l'amor. Metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori l'uscio al tuo cantore. Non sei la luce manca, ove tu sei.
Next.
L'aurora di bianco vestita dischiude geluscio il labor di già con le rozze sue dita carezza di fiori lo suol commosso non fremito arcano intorno creato già par e tu non ti resti eri vano mi sto qui dolente a cantar metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori in luce al tuo cantore ave non sei la luce manca ove tu sei nasce l'amor metti anche tu la veste bianca e sfiori luce al tuo cantare ave non sei la luce manca ove tu sei ove tu sei nasce l'amor
bravo congratulations for really going from stage right to stage left. Congratulations.
Oh, thank Which one you. Did you wow. like better? That was Which... yeah, that was different experience totally.
Yeah. Which one did you like better?
A little bit of both. I think yeah. I think a blend of that would be yeah, cuz the arrogance even as a singer, there was just the more confidence. So yeah. There was that energy of confidence.
Yep.
With the arrogance. And then with the more docile singer, the more shy there's more of that an anchor but more of an ethereal anchor that I think would connect really well with the confidence. So I was like it lets me think more beyond the music
yeah
and the technique
yeah
I mean I have to check in once in a while because
yeah heartbeat. Right can y'all drop in the chat which one you like better one or two For me, so this is the beauty of art song, right? You're the director. You can decide whichever color you want to go for. And you can also choose different ones on different nights. Sometimes you do the same recital several times. Right. And you can make the different choices. When you get bored, you're like, today I'm going to be this dude. Today I'm going to be this dude. You know? I will say, I see everybody has said one. And the reason is because vocally, one sets you up for a better vocal performance.
Right. Yeah, I did feel that.
And it's because the arrogance is like, ah, here I am. And when we get like ähnlich, as we would say in German, sometimes here it gets also ähnlich. So then you would have to play with having the like, oh, I'm nervous, but still flowing on the breath while I am nervous. Cause here
yeah,
we...
that's adjust. Yeah. Like, open. Okay.
Yeah. So these are the things we learn only by playing. And right. So I congratulate you fully for going, for really taking the journey. And this is the work of having something that's 1,000% fresh and honest every time. So huge congratulations.
Thank you so much. I really enjoyed it. And this is a new song, and now it feels like it's not new.
I love it. Bravo. Beautiful voice.
And can I just say, there are many a tenor who wishes they had your high notes, Mr. Baritone Jose. I'm speaking from experience as a tenor. So beautiful. All right. Let's see. Next up, we have some Schumann in Der Fremde with Samantha Burke.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Hi, how are you? Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, you're beautiful.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Hi.
Wait, now we lost you. We lost your voice. We see you, but we lost your voice.
She's on mute.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right. My name is Samantha, and I'm going to sing In der Fremde from Schumann's Liederkreis.
That focus, especially at the end, was very, very beautiful.
Thank you.
I think this one also goes back to our beautiful inner cry, right? Why
yes.
Am I seeing you on my screen? Why am I looking? Oh, there we go. Okay. Fantastic. So can you give me... Can you just pant?
Yes.
Good, good, good. So also not just out, but also in.
It's kind of difficult, but yes.
Good, no. Good. It's good that it's difficult because it trains the support, it trains the muscles, it trains everything to just be like. Great. So can you do just pant again and then go right into. I'll still hide.
Sure. With the music or no?
Well, we can try with the music for a while and then, of course, I'm going to cut it. Because I get impatient.
So... Yes.
What did that feel like?
It felt like how I felt 2 hours. Oh, an hour and a half ago.
Yeah.
Yes. It's
but
good.
This is like another of the tricks that I'm saying to like engage you, like trick your brain into being in the mood, in the vocal place, in the everything that you need to be in when they say go. Right? And so You're right on the breath, you're right on the support, you're right on everything, you're ready to spin and go. This vocally sounded so beautiful. So can we go back to that, and can you add back that really beautiful sincerity you had at the end of the song, right? From my homeland beyond the red lightning. Yeah, be there, be in the home.
Necessarily want to be.
Where is that?
I see when I sing this. Mm-hmm. Because I'm talking at the end of the song, I see like a forest or somewhere bushy, green, cold. Mm-hmm. This place is cold. This place is not as warm as where mother and father lived. This is beyond. Where, you know, this is where it's thundering and lightning and scary and,
yeah.
You know.
I love that.
Yes.
And who are you?
I think I am an adolescent because I say mother and father.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of the words that I choose, I'm not someone who has had to be on my own, but I kind of wonder about my, I'm not too young, but I'm young enough that I wonder what would happen to me in the end of, in this place.
Yeah, I think that's a lovely choice. For our purposes today, just, can you just have it be you? Just you as, maybe how as old as you are now. I don't want to get personal and ask if you've ever lost a parent or if you've ever lost someone, and really just sometimes I find for myself I'm able to be more sincere if I just make the character me. And even if you make the choice to be an adolescent, it's adolescent you, because you were in your body during adolescence, right? And maybe there was somebody that you lost when you were young. But in any case, you just make the choice and you make it be you. The character is you. You in this situation. Either you now or you 20 years ago, 10 years ago, whatever it is. Make the character be you. Be more honest. Songs like this are hard in dramatic classes because for myself, I did a master class in at the Franz Schubert Institute called Anselmos, the name has left me now, Am Grabe Anselmos, I think. And my two friends had passed away, and so I used that in that moment of like when I was standing by their grave, and then it made me too emotional to be able to sing, right? And sometimes I think experiences like that are, and these are decisions that you have to make artistically, if you want to come from a real place in that way, and feeling those real feelings that you've felt before,
mm-hmm.
And making it specific, like in this, it's father and mother, but you use something or someone that you've lost, have long been gone. Or these are the two acting schools. It, essentially, we're talking about two different acting schools. The American very often way is more building from the inside out, coming from your own experiences, and having those be used for the character, and building from the outside in is something that is a very European method of acting. That sometimes, if you create these gestures, that will inspire the inside, and the outsiders will feel the inside if you create the outer shell, right? So these are just different schools of acting, and for myself, I do more of this Stanislavski, popular in America, using your own feelings to connect to a limit, because you never want to commercialize your own really meaningful experiences in a way. So this is something that you have to personally find your own line, right? And in something like this, that's very important. Do you want to respond to that at all, and what you feel?
Yes, I'm processing all of that. I'm trying to, this is a piece that, for a song from a set that I know pretty well. It's been, especially this season, it's been sort of on my list. So it's the thing I did my graduate recital with. It's on with this piece. So I think reconnecting back to, I sang this in an early masterclass for this same organization with Mr. Morocco. And I spoke about why I chose it is because I'm here in Atlanta with my family in my mom's house, but I, at the height of the pandemic, I was in New York in my apartment, and that was just not, it didn't, I felt so disconnected, right? And so I kept going back to this leader Christ that I'd sung back in 2015, and it meant something so different in 2020, and today in 2021, it means something even more different. So I'm trying to present, but I'm also trying to present, if that makes sense. I'm sorry, I know there's a lot of people on here, but.
And exactly, which is why I didn't want to like make you go to places that you don't feel like going in public. So.
But just even talking about this, it renews the song. So thank you.
Wonderful. So let's sing, because all of that talking just filled your spirit, and then just sing on the spirit, on the breath. Put yourself in a very specific place. The person is you. Put mm-hmm. yourself in a very specific place. Feel the temperature of the room. Feel the time of day. Feel the person around you, or the emptiness around you. Just make it very specific in that way. And I'm not going to stop you. And you're in control of this space.
Okay.
Oh,
Beautiful. Beautiful. How did that feel?
Thank you. Felt honest. And that's always my hope. Like when I go to sing,
yeah.
Not even to sing well, I know that should be like my thing to sing well, but I hope to sing honestly and that you picked up on that. So thank you.
Yeah, beautiful. There are times that we can't be honest. Like there are two, so I have a friend who says, was it magic? After a performance, she asks, was it magic or was it craft? You know? And because you can't do, it'll never be magic every time. And so we also need craft for the times when, for whatever reason, we can't have magic, right? So I encourage you to focus even more strongly on your consonants.
Okay.
Let me glance. Aus der Heimat hinted in Blitz and Rot, da kommen die Wolken her. I liked that when you were honest, it became a gesture instead of no, because it's part of the cry. Can we just do the ending? And I encourage you, wie bald, yeah? When you say it twice, you can't say it the same way. You're giving me, wie bald, yeah? So just wherever you can, just maybe second half, can you give me the consonant full panting? Yeah. I want two things, panting and consonants.
Panting and consonants, those
yeah.
I can do.
Yeah.
Let me see.
And you can if you want, you can do it a cappella.
Yeah. It's fa sharp. I don't know. Ba-dum, ba-da-dum. It's a mi. The note is mi or is.
Oh, I'm looking at text. Sorry. Wait, I can open
your mic. I think it's V.
Thank you. Viva.
Yeah. Panting, pant first.
Wie bald, kommt die stille Zeit, da ruhe ich auch, da
Lovely. Can I be even more demanding? Wie bald, and like be obnoxious with the length of your consonants.
All right.
Just start it way earlier.
Okay. Wie bald, kommt die stille Zeit, da ruhe ich auch, da ruhe ich auch, und
Great. Lovely. So I loved very much these consonants. Just always make them even earlier. You have a tendency to drag on the late side of the beats. And I want you like, just in general, just earlier and roll. Yeah. Cause you want to like hold onto them like this, like pull-ups. And I want you to like flow like a river on top of it.
I like that image.
Yeah. it's a lot of the same thing we were talking to. Who were we talking to about it? I don't remember. But the same like river imagery. Were you here when we were talking about all of that?
Yes, I was. Yes, so I heard it.
That's the universe that you need to live in. Repeated notes, river flowing on top of it, the panting, the inner cry, anything that makes your voice move, because you like holding on to it, and we need you to flow like a river on top of it. Yeah? Can you give me just like a phrase of that with that thought?
Yeah. My hardest phrase in the song, da-da-da-dum.
Difference.
It really does help that motion, the movement.
Yeah, brava, brava. Mm-hmm. Anybody thought for you? What is your takeaway?
I'm so happy that you picked up on honesty, and I do have a question at the end about this. I guess when we have time, just because I've been singing a lot, and how to like. Re-imbue and like really I've been learning things quickly, like I should say, and do it right, and repeating a lot of things, so one have that question. But I also really like the idea of earlier consonants. Mm-hmm. I think part of my voice, like you said to another singer, have people told you that you have a big voice or something like that, and so I try not to think so heavy, but I think of like pulling like that, like for the support.
No pulling. Okay. No.
Well,
pulling.
I like this river thing because that helps.
Yeah.
that helps because my voice can get weighed down easily.
Yes, it can.
So those things resonated with me the most, and then my consonants will have more meaning once I put it in me.
Yeah.
I think so. Thank you.
Yeah, you said how repeating things. So I mentioned very briefly Stanislavski. A lot of the questions that I'm asking you, they always, part of Stanislavski is these like six questions of who, what, when, where, why, how. Mm-hmm. Like what's the obstacle in the way? I don't know how many of you have played with this idea, but these are questions that you have to have all of the answers to before you start singing your song. And when you have these questions very specifically answered in your head, then you can just play. And in the same way that José took the same song and basically made it two completely different characters, this is one of the ways when you have to repeat things. You can just play. Today it's going to be this. Tomorrow it's going to be this. And today I'm feeling like this, and that's what it's going to be. And tomorrow I'm like in a really good mood, and that's what it's going to be. And, you know, so you have, there's no this is how you sing that song. Who you are in this moment is who's going to sing that song. And you're never going to be in that moment again. So it'll never be the same.
I would agree. Thank you.
Remind me a second question.
The second question is, I guess it's part of the first one. So I'm singing quite a lot of different things right now. And I'm singing Carmen, and I'm also singing, I'm a soprano, not a mezzo, but my school asked me to do Carmen, so I'm doing Carmen, and that's fine. And having to put out that and gigs and learn new music and, you know, to make money, like how everybody else is making money, and how to, I try to incorporate a lot of this Stanislavski, the Utahagen, the different things like that into my singing all the time. And I find, and I think what you said works, but how to, I think sometimes I'm trying to do something honestly, but how to make it fresh, you know, like especially these are so many different
So I think you don't need to try to make it fresh, because then you'll it'll never be honest if you're trying to make it fresh, right? Mm. If you just accept, I'm a different person than I was yesterday when I sang this, and be you in that moment, this character as you, in this mood, in this space, with these people. Sometimes you can change who you're singing it to. Like, that's something I've done before. Like, one time it's to somebody I love, and another time it's a person to somebody I'm a little bit jealous of, and sometimes it's, you know, you can play, and all of those different choices will change who will change the performance. So don't try to make it fresh. Be you in that moment making decisions.
That's easy enough to do.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Great job, Samantha. I'm really loving this, the sighing and the breathing that you're having them do, Raehann. I noticed both in Samantha and Latoya, who are singers with such enormous ability to reveal pain in their voice when they're at their best. Your exercise just truly allowed that Sturm und Drang to kind of flow it out. So thank you for doing that with them. Okay, and our last singer for the day, the very opposite of Sturm und Drang, is going to be Zweimung. Maria, are you ready?
Yes, let me... One second.
Make sure I got all... And I'll drop the text to Zweimung in the Dropbox. Vaguely, you may want to be a little closer. Yeah, I guess it's going to all depend when you start singing. Do you want to maybe sing a line and we can tell you? I'll let Raehann, since she's going to be working, if she hears well enough, that's what's important.
Where's your where are your speakers with your piano?
Back here. Put it somewhere else.
Can you bring them closer, possibly? I'm mostly annoyed because I have the speaker view and you're not loud enough to make yourself be the speaker. So maybe come a bit closer, cause so then I can see you better.
Okay. Ich bin von dir, ich bin lieber mag die Herzen krank. Aber dank, einst hielt ich dir Freiheit sicher, auch den Mangel ist in mich. Oh!
Brava. So, who are you?
So this to me, I mean, the poetry seems a little generic in terms of just being longing love, I guess. Two people who are very far apart, who are very in love and yearning for each other. But it sounds to me from the words that I'm the one who made the journey away. It says that I torment myself far from you. So it seems like I'm the one who went away. And I love him so much that it's making me sick, but it's a good kind of hurt, because the whole song sounds exuberant, but it's not when you actually read the text of it.
So yeah.
To me, it seems like I said it like before we had like easy modes of transportation, since it was written in the late 1880s. So that's what it kind of seems to me. So I'm thinking like some kind of ship journey. I don't know. So I'm, you know, quite a far away, and like letter writing is the only way to talk to my love.
So is this a letter? Is this you writing a letter?
No. I think this is me. This is an internal remembrance.
Like, oh, you're memory. Not.
I'm thinking, I'm far away, and I'm thinking, you know, like the scenes you always see, the people looking yearningly out the window. Like, and it's just to me, it's internal.
Yeah. I think that's an absolutely fair choice. I used to have a teacher who would ask me, is that the hottest choice?
The hottest choice.
You know, because it is a very valid choice, and if you want to fight for it, it's your art, and you can absolutely do that. But sometimes it's, especially in art song, we have to do even more work to create the world and make it really specific, and it's helpful if you have someone to sing it to. But if you want to fight for it, I'll come along with the journey. Do you want to fight for it?
I mean, the letter makes sense too, though. It is very, because it's very poetry and florid and.
No, I'm not fighting for the letter.
Love letter that you would.
I'm not. Yeah. Yeah, but I'm not fighting for the letter. I'm fighting for you to be saying these words to your partner.
Okay, I see. So like, but we're closer than I think we are. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I mean, it could be that you left, and then you come back and you're like, I'm so grateful for you. You know, that's, yeah, that it was so painful to be away from you. And I'm so grateful that.
Now I have thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can we try that? Mm-hmm. Okay. So where are you right now then?
Like in my world?
Yeah.
It would be like the first meeting when I'm back with.
I love it. Where are you? Is this. You said it's like 1800s.
A ship dock.
I like it. So are you like deboarding right now? I was going to say deplaning, but are you like coming down the ramp?
Titanic, if it would have actually not sunk. Like, made it across the inter-ocean.
Right.
Journey. Yeah.
And where is that person?
They're on the dock waiting. Like below, you go down the really long ramp. They're all lying.
Good. So are you like walking as you're singing? No.
I don't see it as a,
You stop on the dock and you're like, oh.
Or maybe I'm just waiting for my turn to go down.
Okay. I buy that. And you're saying these very personal words from the dock, from the.
Sure. No. Everyone should know.
I'm with you.
It either needs to be still, like it's to him in our little moment, or it's up, anticipating the.
Which one is it? Pick it. You pick.
It'll be the meeting, the actual meeting.
I like it. Okay. So
intimacy to it.
I like it. So now where are you specifically?
On the dock.
Okay. And there are lots of people around.
Yeah, there are lots around, but no one's paying attention to us because everyone else is doing their own thing. So it's
good.
Like in the movie when there's lots of motion, but really you're only focusing.
I love it. Yeah. Let's sing it again, and with that in that universe.
Okay. Is that an okay volume?
I can't hear it at all.
Oh,
Lovely, lovely. I loved it. I loved it. Thank you. That changed so much and made it much more honest. Can we do a camera trick? Because nowadays we have to perform for camera. Can you make the person be right there into the camera? Like, really sing to them. Those are their eyes. You're singing into their eyes. You can keep going if you want. Cool. Can you stomp? Yeah. Stomp again really hard. Yeah. Can you imbue this? There's so many layers to this, and right now you're giving me the top layer. Were you faithful when you were away?
Yes.
You were faithful. Was he faithful?
I don't know.
What are some of the hardships that you guys have had to go through before?
Not even knowing if you're gonna make it back.
Yeah.
A more, like, I don't know, harder degree of separation, I guess.
Yeah. Can you just be unfaithful?
Okay.
And can he have found out about it? Okay. And can he have forgiven you?
Okay. Sure.
And this is the first time you're seeing him. Yeah, so there's not just that, yeah, it's like, this is me, and I'm telling you this because I'm so grateful for what you've done for us, to accept me as imperfect as I am. Like, just give it a whole different layer of truth to it, yeah? Great. Can you just speak the words? Yeah. In character. Prepare yourself. You're like, I don't even know what to say to you right now. Ja, du weißt es, Toya Seele. Yeah?
Ja, du weißt es, Toya Seele, dass ich fern von dir mich quäle.
Yeah. You are giving me a poetry reading, and I do not want that. I want, like, realness.
Weißt es, teure Seele, dass ich fern von dir mich quäle. Liebe macht die Herzen krank. Habe Dank.
Yeah. So it's a big deal to say habe Dank. Yeah? Mich quäle, Liebe macht die Herzen krank. Habe Dank. Yeah? Make it a hard thing for those words to come out. Go on.
Eins hielt ich der Freiheit sicher. Hoch den Arm tiefst den Becher und du segnetest den Tag.
Cool, 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 cool. So can we go away for einst, like once? Einst hielt ich dir Freiheit sicher. We need for a second. Let's talk about sicher. The ich laut. Freiheit sicher hoch den Arme tüsten. Tüste, amethyste, and you're giving me amethyste.
With the I?
Yeah, and it's like IPA, it's a Y. Amethyste Becher. It's been a while since I've worked with an IPA. Anyway, but anyway, point is, can we go away for it? So first verse, you're with him. Ja, du weißt es heute, and then like, go away. This is the time that you were unfaithful. You're thinking about the time that you had all this freedom, and even though you did all of this awful stuff, he forgave you. But go away for that time, that once I held freedom's cup, whatever.
Start with a second.
Yeah. That's so different. That's so different. Doesn't that feel way more honest? Mm-hmm. And if you make it that you don't have to follow the rhythm of the piece, it'll be even more, it'll put it even on another level. So can you play with that being even more?
Yeah. Yeah. Same one or the next?
Yeah, same one. Go away and really remember the time that you held freedom's cup and, you know, whatever happened.
Einst hielt ich der Freiheit sicher, hoch den Arm tiefsten Becher, und du segnetest den Trank. Habe Dank.
Brava. Going on.
Und beschworz darin die Böse. Bis ich, was ich nie gewesen, heilig, heilig an Herz dir Dank, habe Dank.
Let's sing.
Du weißt es, teure Seele, dass ich fern von dir mich quäle. Immer mach die Herzen trank. Hab Dank. Einst hielt ich dir Freiheit sicher, hoch den Arm tiefst den Becher, und du segnetest den Trank, habe Dank. Und beschworst du in die Böse, wie schießt, was ich nie gewesen.
Brava. This was, how did that feel?
Good. Much more layered.
Yeah, I agree. Let's add a couple layers on top of that. When you go away, can you look another direction? Because on stage, right now you're giving me this and then this, which isn't big enough to read on stage, right?
Right.
So I loved the eye connection. And then can you just look away for Eins hielt ich der Freiheit Zeche, hoch den Arme tüsten Bäche, und du segnetest den Drank. You can come back then if you want, or stay. You like, it hurts too much to even look at him. Und du segnetest den Drank. Dank. Yeah,
okay.
But really, really come away for the changes. Also, I think rhythm is going to help you. Right now, you're giving me. Ja, du weißt es, teure Seele. Then there's this moment of pause. And you're coming in early, which takes away this moment of like. I don't even, yeah. So be sure you're giving me, you're not coming in too early there on that connection. Do you know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So let's do that again and give me the ABA version of, ja, du weißt, eins hielt ich, whatever the third verse is coming back.
Du weißt es, teure Seele, dass ich fern von dir mich quäle. Lieber macht die Herzen krank.
Great. Can I just fix it really quickly? So, sorry.
Yeah.
Great. I want you to run it, but I want you to just... Ja, du weißt es, teure Seele. Dass ich fern von dir, dass ich fern von dir. Think about that rhythm. You, maybe not fixed for today, but just know that you need to look at it. Yeah?
Is that one different than the second one? Sorry, am I just, I thought that was on the beat. I get that
wrong. We look at it later. We look at it later for later, but they're wrong. So fix it later.
Du weißt es, teure Seele, dass ich fern von dir mich quäle. Lieber macht die Herzen krank. Aber dank, einst hielt ich dir Freiheit Zeche, hoch den Arm.
So many beautiful things about that. Can we just do the ending? And can you give me all of your explosiveness and less control? Like when we were talking about Olivia being more spontaneous. Heilig, heilig, ans Herz, not heilig, 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 heilig. This is a combination of everything from today. This breathlessness and also just the explosion of energy, because this is our climax and you have this note like so easily. And can you just add just all of your gratefulness and all of your energy poured into this moment. Heilig, heilig ans Herz dir sank. Yeah?
Okay.
Let's just do that ending.
Okay.
Lovely, so lovely. You can go even further.
Okay.
You can go even further. You have more breath than you think. Herz dir sank, sank, habe. And then this is another pouring moment. With all of your breath, all of your energy, all of your inner cry. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want to try it again? Or you?
Yeah. Just the end.
Yeah. Because I feel like you have another level, and I want it. I want all of it. Yes, beautiful. And you can stay holding the note after the piano if you want to really be a diva. Don't tell the pianist I said so. But they will, and I say that, but they're going to hold it with you because they're looking to cut off with you. But the problem with these mechanical things now is our singing can become mechanical, and we never want that. You do what is organic to you, no matter who is playing or what machine is playing. Yeah. If you want to hold that note, you freaking hold that note, because that's all we care about in that moment. Yeah. So brava, brava, brava.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Excellent job. Excellent work together. You know, my takeaway watching the wonderful work that you've done today, Raehann, with the singers is really, you can't get away with not having specificity, because the moment you add the specificity, the voice comes alive, and it's an honest portrayal of the music, of the singer, and you have to give who you really are. And so thank you for that. It was beautiful to watch the work that you've done.
Yay, bravi tutti, bravi.
So, and thank you, singers. Let's give our guest artists and our singers, your colleagues, a round of applause. You can unmute yourself if you have a question, but thank you very much, Raehann. This was marvelous.
Yay. Please, if you have questions.
Yes, do we have any questions from singers or from anyone else who observed?
I have a question. So do you think it's better to go way too far so that the director or someone can pull you back?
Every director will ask that of you.
Mm-hmm.
Will be so, I won't say ask that of you. He or she will be grateful for the opportunity to pull you back. So grateful. And sometimes you work with directors that are very uninspired, or it's their first time doing an opera, and they're just like, yeah, singers can't do this. And they won't ask more of you. They won't even know that you're capable. So you always live on 1000% energy and let them pull you back. Your job is to take care of your instrument, which means that if you're on your support and you're not grabbing, you can do anything. You can play with anything. But you do have to make sure that you can sing the next show. So you give everything with no pressure here, staying on the breath, but giving everything always. Anybody else?
I have a question. Hi. So what have you learned about singing, I guess, or yourself during this time? I watched your recital. It was very, with, I think, was your husband playing? Was really nice. It's really, really nice. But what have you learned during this time about yourself as a singer?
Well, okay. So this time, of course, financially has been a disaster for all of us, right? But what this time has given us is complete creative control, right? And that's what I've always loved about art songs, is that you have complete creative control. There's no director on stage telling you this is what this means, this is what this looks like. It's you that are able to do that. There's no conductor saying this has to go this tempo. It's only that you and your pianist have to agree. And when you are creating content, which is what we're doing now, you have complete creative control. You decide who you work with, you decide what pieces you choose, you decide what message you want to say. During this, I had work, and I was fulfilling a lot of different directors' visions, and all of a sudden during this pandemic, I can create whatever I want. So this brown sounds that Blair just spoke about at the beginning of this, I chose the composer, I commissioned a composer, I hired a director, I hired a videographer, I hired a dancer, I hired a fashion designer, I chose the locations, I chose what the concept was. This is unheard of. This is unheard of in what the world was before as an opera singer, right? These are the things you see Beyonce doing because she's Beyonce, you know? Usually there isn't space for opera singers to do that. And now all of a sudden we're seeing a new world that if you're only limited by your ideas, right? I found people who funded it because I didn't have money to film that kind of stuff. I found donors. You're only limited by your ethic and your ideas. And this is a new horizon, and I don't know that I will be able to go back completely to only executing other people's visions. And that's what I'm grateful for about this time.
Wow, it's fantastic.
Yeah. In recital, do you have a favorite lead composer or a composer that you sing the most? Schubert, Schumann, Brahms, Wolf, Strauss? Which lead composer do you favor or sing the most in recital?
I don't know that I have a most, because I usually glide through all of the ones that you just said. I will say that my favorite piece to perform is Verlassen by Schoenberg. I get so sad that he went off into his 12-tone world, because his expressionistic stuff, like right before he left, is just amazing. Like the colors that he was creating, which had all this crunch, which I'm obsessed with, but crunch for the sake of creating colors, I find just amazing. So yeah. But of course, also the melodies of Brahms. Brahms was a gift to mezzos. Mahler. I'm dying to sing all the Mahler.
you would do those very beautifully, yeah. And just to piggyback on that, I guess, do you find that the German song is a good vehicle, one of the better vehicles for you, or is there another genre that you enjoy? Do you enjoy the Italian, the French, or there's something outside, the Russian music? Have you looked into any Rachmaninoff?
Rachmaninoff is beautiful. It's beautiful and it fits my voice really well.
I can see that. Yeah, I would think so.
But I love I haven't taken the time to live in the Russian language to be able to be specific enough mm-hmm. in colors as I would like to be. Mm-hmm. So I don't do it very often.
Yeah.
And German is certainly my mood. I connect more with that way of connecting to emotions. The French with their lovely flowers and things, the whole impressionistic era, I could do without. Like, I don't go to that part of the museum. I walk by while going to contemporary art. So 1000%, if I'm doing a recital that I have complete control of, the first half is German, the second half is American relevant composers. Ideally really emphasizing composers of color and women and text that is really relevant right now.
Yeah, and just for anyone who's building a program, that's the key to helping maintain the relevance of art song. So we have to thank artists like, you know, Raehann for doing that, because otherwise people, you know, we're kind of at an inflection point for this genre of music, which, you know, I love so much. And so trying to figure out how to make Gretchen am Spinnrad relevant. And there are so many ways you can. I mean, as Raehann said, you're only limited by your own imagination and vision and commitment to that. So thank you again, Raehann, for today and for working with the singers. Thank you, singers, for your talent and your openness, because it's not easy to work in a masterclass setting and be asked something to reveal yourself and to make changes. So continue to reflect on what she said and do those changes, you know, in the privacy of your own home when you don't have people looking at you. Do it right there, because it's a lot harder to do with an audience. Thank you again, Raehann. This has been amazing. I can't wait to see the video on March 26th. So I encourage you all to check it out on the LA Opera website, Raehann's new video. So thank you.
Thank you all. Bravi tutti.
Thank you. Have a wonderful afternoon, everyone. And I look forward to seeing you again soon.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye.